Hi, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. This is the second episode for the HIV series. I hope the previous video explaining HIV was educational for you. In this week's video, I want to share with you the tests we can do to detect HIV and the treatment for HIV. If you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. In general, testing for HIV can be done via samples taken from the vein and sent to the lab, finger prick rapid test kits, or oral saliva test kits. Three types of tests that we can do would be, first of all, a nucleic acid test, or NAT for short. A NAT test looks for the actual virus in the blood. It can diagnose HIV as early as 10 days after you've been exposed. Blood is drawn from the vein, and the results may take weeks to be available. It is generally not used as a routine screening test as it is very expensive, and in Singapore, it may cost up to $600 for a test. However, it may be useful if other tests are indeterminate. Secondly, a HIV antibody testing. This test looks for antibodies to HIV in your blood or oral fluid. Antibodies are produced by your immune system after you've been exposed to the HIV virus. The test usually turns positive within 4 to 8 weeks of an infection. Presence of antibody indicates presence of HIV virus. So venous sampling, finger prick testing, and oral saliva testings are all available for HIV antibody tests. The third method is the HIV antibody and antigen combination test. This test checks for a particular P24 antigen that is produced by the HIV virus that can show up within 2 to 4 weeks after infection. At the same time, it checks also for HIV antibodies. This test is fast becoming the first test we do if you suspect an HIV infection. Venous sampling and finger prick testing are available for this test. On a practical level in a clinic, we would usually do a HIV antibody or an antibody-antigen combination test as the initial screening test. And if this were positive in Singapore, we will send the sample to the lab for a special confirmatory test. Take note that there is a lag time between the point of exposure and when your blood becomes detectable for HIV. And this window period typically is about 3 months. Therefore, if there is a very high suspicion of HIV infection and your first test was negative, please repeat another test 3 months after the initial exposure. Please consult your doctor for more detail on the timing for this test. There are some clinics in Singapore that offer anonymous HIV testing. No identifiable information will be taken during anonymous testing. In Singapore, a person with HIV infection is required by law to reveal his health status to the sexual partner before sexual activities. He or she is required also by law to reveal his health status to medical personnel or dentists before any invasive procedures. However, a person who is HIV positive does not require to have his health status revealed to anyone else, including employers or relatives, because the identity of the person is protected and unauthorized disclosure of health information is prohibited to prevent the exposure of identity. Under the Infectious Disease Act, a positive test for HIV is notifiable to the Ministry of Health. So now let's move on to the treatment of HIV. The treatment of HIV is called antiretroviral therapy, or ART for short. This drug prevents HIV from multiplying, and this gives the immune system a chance to recover and produce more CD4 cells. Even though there is still some HIV virus in the body, the immune system is strong enough to fight off the infections. ART involves taking a combination of HIV medications on a daily basis and is recommended for everyone who has HIV. ART cannot cure HIV, but can help people with HIV live a longer, healthier life. The main goal of HIV treatment is to reduce a person's viral load to an undetectable level. And in next week's video, I will share how this is crucial in preventing the transmission of HIV. Antiretroviral therapy, or ART, has to be taken lifelong. Follow-ups are essential to check for effectiveness of the therapy, side effects of therapy, and whether there are any complications arising from the HIV itself. In Singapore, as of September 2020, about 16 antiretroviral drugs have been added to the list of subsidized drugs. This means that all subsidized patients living with HIV now will receive either a 50% or 75% subsidy depending on their means test status when they buy any of the 16 medications. So financial help is available. Do not be afraid to seek treatment or help. Thanks for watching till the end. I hope that this was informative enough for you. And in next week's video, I will share more on the prevention of HIV through lifestyle and medications. Subscribe, like, and share. Until the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.